Excuse me. Hi guys, it's Mike here, One Go Short Play, and we're playing Chou Touryuu Retsuden. That's why it's a D in the C's, because it originally listed as a Japanese name. I'm getting a bit annoyed that so many Japanese games are coming up in C that aren't C. Like, this one clearly isn't. Anyway, I'm going to play it anyway because, well, I can't guarantee that I'll get to play Dino Land when I hit D. So, Chou Thingy Retsuden. I will have forgotten that name by the end of the video as well. Dino Land on the Sega Mega Drive. Let's play it. I've never seen this before. Oh, pinball. I said that like I'm excited. I'm not mad on pinball games. Even the Mighty Crew Ball, which this looks like it plays like with the little characters. Which people say is a really underrated game. I've forgotten how to play pinball on the Mega Drive. I remember. Let's just find the button for the right flipper. There it is. Okay, we've got it. Let's try that again. Yeah, I mean, I loved Motley Crue when I was a kid. I know. I still think they had the moments. Motley Crue had a brilliant little period in 1995 when they got John Corabi as a singer and totally changed the sound. And despite me loving them when I was younger, you know what? I'm going to save this conversation because we're going to hit crew ball at some point. And I will continue that. But anyway, because this isn't even relevant to this game. This is cool. The frame rate feels a little bit low. It's pinball. It's a pinball game. It's quite a good pinball game. Because it doesn't overface you, as pinball games often do for non-pinball players like myself. And I have to admit, I really like the characterizations. I like games with characters in. I don't really like games with abstracts in. So I was never a big pinball fan generally. This is... The character stuff really, really works for this game. I like the little dinosaurs coming out of the big dinosaurs, although the animation's a bit off there, but that's alright. I like it. I like it a lot. Why is that little dinosaur up there suddenly a king? Ooh! There was a big rock in the way blocking... Hang on, I can't lose. Yeah, I can't lose. Unless it slips under me flipper. Or down the side. Oh no, even then there's a thing. Yes, that's why I'm not losing. Maybe that's why I like this game, because I'm... Doing the illusion of doing so well at it is making me feel good. If I hadn't seen that big rock between me flippers, I'd have been... That sounded rude. I'm not sure why. But it just did. If I hadn't seen that big rock between me flippers, I'd have thought I was brilliant. Oh, I think I'm getting a cold, so I do apologise for all the sniffing. I also do apologise for all the... I've just forgot my train of thought halfway through. Yes, the noise on the microphone, I'm aware. I've just watched one of my videos back, or a bit of it, which I don't do enough at the moment. Whoa, is that a level? Oh, level boss. Oh, there's no rock now. Oh, I am rubbish. Oh, no, my rock's gone from here as well. Oh, this is it, guys. Game over. Game over. Hang on. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Noise on the microphone. Basically, what it is, you might remember a while ago, someone suggested, I think it was Steve Smith, suggested I know two Steve Smiths. One's the game developer Steve Smith, who was part of Super Smith Brothers, and now is part of, I forgot what they're called, but they did that Gear Gauntlet game, which is very nice. I've not played it, but it looks pretty amazing. And there's another Steve Smith that... does the retro gaming fairs that I went to university with, and those of you who are retro gamers will probably know him for, if you're, especially if you're in the Yorkshire area, retro gaming fairs in Leeds. I designed his logo. A little bit of trivia for you there. For the retro gaming fair and for Collectorabilia. Anyway, yeah, Steve Smith, the developer one, not the retro gaming fair one. Oh, come on, I hate that. That's just not right. Suggested that I get a pop shield. And I did, and it was brilliant, and it worked, but it was cheap, so it wasn't designed to fit me. And again, give me a bit more play. Go on, just a bit more. No, that is it. Yeah, it wasn't designed to fit my microphone, and it all came to a head the other day when I tried to put all this back together, and it fell apart. Literally fell apart, and all the wiring, because it's held together with, like, bouncy little cables and stuff that keeps it from, you know, reverberating. And which is great, but... Oh, continue. But it all fell apart. And I'm having trouble getting it all back together again. and I might just, you know, use Sellotape. But hey, if you've seen my talkie, you'll know that's very much in keeping with how I do things on this channel. Because, we don't do expensive kit here at One Go Short Play. We film on an iPhone. We use broken equipment. And we're proud of it. Well, not really, but that's the way it is. I'm quite liking this game. I think I'm liking talking nonsense at you more than this game. It's alright, it's a pinball game. Much is to me. There are a few. Dragon's Fury, that was very, very... why did they move? That was very, very... a different approach on pinball. And we will get to it because we'll hit D at some point. That said, I'm finding I do A, B and C on a machine and then I move to another one. And I'll probably come back and do D, E, F. And it'll probably work a bit like that because let's face it, who wants to sit and wait for A, B, C? You know, the whole alphabet to go by on just one machine when there's the option of seeing lots of other ones. I've just cared to me, those little dinosaurs I keep hitting are just in the way, aren't they? I mean, they give you points, but it's about progress, this game. And I've got to get up there. And that boss that you saw a glimpse of before, come on. Oh, that's not on. That you saw a glimpse of before, get up there, no, go that way. Hang on, can I move then? No, of course not. That'd be silly. That'd be brilliant, but no, it's just a pinball game. That boss was clearly where I'm meant to get to, which is cool. I think I would probably play this game a bit more. It wouldn't make me Mega Drive collection, though, because I wouldn't play enough. Even think back in the day, I wasn't that into pinball. It just didn't feel substantial enough. I mean, I know people like pinball, and I can kind of see why. It's especially the tables, because they're very visceral things, aren't they? Big metal coils and springs and stuff bouncing violently against the ball. And this is all going a bit saucy again, isn't it? There's something very tactile about a pinball machine. Not that I'm into it. Oh, is this a boss? Did it manage it? Yes! Maybe it's a score you've got to get. Oh, you're going down, boss. Have that. And that. That's it. You've got just walk into the ball. Yes! Oh. I nearly swore then. Oh, well, that's not fair. That wasn't right. It just... he laughed and I went back. Sorry, that was a bit whimpery, wasn't it? I was really disappointed there. I thought I had him on the ropes, on the rocks, whatever they say. Come on, I got a score, let's go back to the boss. We've seen this enough now. In fact, we have seen this enough. Not bad. I would probably play this for a good hour or so if I didn't have loads more games to play. Let's play some of them. That was a Japanese name beginning with C on the Mega Drive that I can't remember. But it translates to Dino Land, and I'm only playing it now because I can't guarantee it'll be in D, and I'm using the Japanese name as justification to play it. You watch it, it'll be in D, and I'll have to play it again. Not necessarily, it's up to me, it's my channel. But yeah, that was that. I've looked at the list on the games because I was getting a bit annoyed by all these C-based Japanese games that were actually beginning in C in my alphabetical listing, and this is the last of them, I think, for a while at least, so... we'll be back to playing English names now. Hey! Right, that was that game, beginning with C, that's called Dino Land in English. Thanks for watching. See you in the next vid.